Do you remember that bit of my January book haul where I said something like, and there probably aren't going to be any book hauls for a couple of months? About that. Basically, February is my birthday month, and between that and I did buy a couple of things for myself and I got a couple of pre-orders in, I ended up with enough stuff to warrant filming a February book haul. So that is what we're going to do today now. So I'm going to start off with the one book that I received for review, and this is an anthology called If This Goes On, edited by Kat Rambo. Parvis Press reached out to me and said, would you like a review copy of this? And I said, yes, because I've heard of that before and it sounds quite interesting. Also, E. Lily Yu has the story in this, and I will basically read anything that has a story by her in it. I'm quite an E. Lily Yu fan. So I'm just gonna quickly read what's on the back of this. The tagline is, the science fiction future of today's politics. Some of today's most visionary writers of science fiction project us forward to the world of the future, a world shaped by nationalism, isolationism, and a growing divide between the haves and the have-nots. This anthology sits at the intersection of politics, speculative fiction, and American identity. Yes, I'm definitely interested in this. I think it comes out in a week or two. I've misplaced the sell sheet, but I will put the publication date down in the description below in case you were interested. And then, like I said, I did give in to temptation and I bought two books for myself. I was in a couple of used bookstores and I thought I was doing really good with only walking out of there with two rather than like 10, which is what I usually do when I'm at half price. So I found a copy of the Fantasy Masterworks edition of Something Wicked This Way Comes by Ray Bradbury. Thank you to whoever it was who told me that this actually existed. I had convinced myself for years that it didn't actually exist. Probably because the cover art is really, really different from the cover art on the other books in this line. But it does exist. It has the right spine and everything. So I've actually already read this book a couple of years ago, and my vague memory of it is that I liked the atmosphere, it was well written, but I wasn't like super into the story. It probably warrants a reread though, because I really feel like I should read more by Bradbury. Like, I will probably like his books, I just don't make time to really read them or whatever. We'll see, but I have this nice copy of it now. But the other book that I picked up was the one that I literally snatched off the shelf and went, oh, I have to get this. It's the reason why I broke my book buying ban in February, because I could have walked out of the bookstore without the Fantasy Masterworks. I know I can get that somewhere else. But this one, guys, I found a copy of The Collected Short Fiction of C.J. Cherry. I don't know if this is out of print or not, but I have never seen a copy of this before. And I actually didn't even know that Cherry wrote short fiction until a little while ago. She's always struck me as a science fiction writer who writes novels and pretty much nothing else. This is not a short collection though. It's over 600 pages long. I have a ton of unread C.J. Cherry on my shelves. I will probably get through more of the Company Wars books before I get to this collection, so we'll have to wait for a while, but I'm so happy I finally found a copy. Next are things that I got for my birthday, and the first two are from Andrea over at Infinite Text. I'm pretty sure she's like one of the sweetest, loveliest people on the face of the planet. She sent me two books for my birthday, and the first one has a story. You may remember that one of my favorite books of 2018 was Kelly Robson's Gods, Monsters, and the Lucky Peach. And when I was at Worldcon in San Jose, I bought a copy of it for myself, a physical copy, and it was like the one thing I wanted to get signed at the convention, but I missed Kelly Robson's autographing session and then I never saw her again there. I think she got sick or something. So I didn't get that copy signed. But Robson is Canadian, Andrea is Canadian, and so Andrea went to an event where Kelly Robson was and she got me a signed copy of Gods, Monsters, and the Lucky Peach, and I am just in love with this. Thank you so much, Andrea. So I have an extra copy that I will probably give away to somebody, but this one is special now. And apparently Kelly Robson knows who I am, which is pretty awesome. So I have this now, and she also sent me a copy of Austral by Paul McCauley, which is another one of the books that I think I was really anticipating this in 2017 when it came out. I'm starting to lose track of when things come out. It's climate change science fiction, and I was never able to read it because I could never find a copy, but now I have one thanks to Andrea, so I'm really looking forward to this one. These next couple of books are also birthday gifts from my family. My parents got me All Systems Red and Rogue Protocol by Martha Wells. These are the first and third novellas in the Murderbot series. I'm so happy I have all of them in matching editions now. Sometimes it matters to me a lot that my books match, what can I say? And All Systems Red is now available in the hardcover re-release. So I plan on doing a reread of all of the novellas all at once. I'm actually leading the read-along for Artificial Condition, the second one, in April, I think, for the Book 2 SFF Awards, so I'll probably just do a full reread in April. I love Murderbot so much. And the other book from my parents that I got already is Giant Days Volume 9 by John Allison. You know, I love Giant Days. It's a contemporary comic about three friends in university in England and all the crazy stuff that happens to them. I've actually already read this volume and I really loved it. There are some things that happen with the characters, particularly with Daisy and her really horrible girlfriend. I thought there was some good development there. So yeah, can't wait for volume 10. I consume Giant Days so fast. I wish it came out faster. My brother got me a gift card, so I used it to pre-order some more February and March releases, and one of those has shown up so far, and that is The Raven Tower by Anne Leckie. This is her first fantasy novel, and I believe it is set in the same world that she's written some short stories in that I really enjoyed, so I'm really looking forward to this. I know it's not going to be anything like her science fiction. It's not going to be like the Imperial Ratch books, which I love so much, but it is Anne Leckie. I'm going to enjoy the writing and the world building and all of that. And I think I'm going to skip reading the description of this again. I actually kind of want to go into it relatively blind without too many assumptions or expectations. And these last two books I have to show you are gorgeous and large, and I'm so excited that they finally came. So back in early 2018, I think, so almost a year ago, I backed the Kickstarter for Sunspot Jungle, which is an anthology from Rosarium Publishing to celebrate, I think, 5 years in business for them. And just the lineup of authors they had for the anthology was astonishingly good. So I backed it, and I finally got my Kickstarter hardcover edition. So we have volume 1 of Sunspot Jungle and volume 2. And this is about 1,000 pages of short stories right here. And when I say that there are some really, really exciting authors in this, I'm not exaggerating. Just in this first volume, some of the people, not all of them, but some of them in here are Basma Abdel Aziz, who wrote The Q, Saladin Ahmed, Charlie Jane Anders, K. Tempest Bradford, Jennifer Brissett, Maurice Broaddus, Christopher Brown, Joyce Ching, John Chu, Corinne Dalvis, Amal El-Motar, Tang Fei, Jeffrey Ford, Hiromi Goto, N.K. Jemison, Victor Laval, Rose Lemberg, Karen Loachy, Sylvia Moreno-Garcia, Christine Ong Moslem, Ramez Nam, Shweta Narayan, Malka Older, Sarah Pinsker, Jeff Ryman, Angela Slater, and those are just the ones that I recognize their names in this one and I'm excited about. Let's look at volume 2 as well. Some of the people in here are Brooke Bolander, Tobias S. Buckle, Raquel Castro, P. Jelly Clark, you know I want to read that now, Inderpamit Das, Del Mandila, Tananarive Du, Fabio Fernandez, Max Gladstone, Jamie Goh, Nick Harkaway, Carlos Hernandez, Nalo Hopkinson, Emmy Itaranta has a story in here, I did not know that. Ken Liu, Karen Lord, Carmen Maria Machado, Nick Mamatas, Haralambi Markov, Foz Meadows, Sunny Moraine, Daniel Jose Older, Rebecca Roanhorse, Nisi Shawl, Narudama Sundar, Jeremy Saul, Bogi Takash, Natalia Theodoridou, Cherie Renee Thomas, Lavi Tidar, and Sabrina Vorvulius. Oh, I don't know how to say her last name, but I recognize her name. These also have illustrations inside of them. So some of the stories have full page illustrations like this. So yeah, they are just gorgeous, gorgeous books, and I can't wait to start reading them. I am not entirely sure if these are available to purchase now. Possibly the ebooks are and the paperbacks are coming out later in 2019, but I think that the hardcover editions might be special editions for the Kickstarter only. I should probably fact check myself on that one though. If you can get them, do, because they look amazing. So those are all the things that I got in February. We will see if my book acquisition slows down in March at all. It's not that I'm trying to restrict the number of books that I get this year, that's not necessarily true, but I am trying to limit how much I spend on them. And honestly, I did a really good job at not spending too much on books in both January and February. So I am happy with that. Let me know if you have read any of these or if you're excited about them as well. I really need to knuckle down and read what I am getting a bit faster this year. If I want to achieve my goal of getting my physical TBR down to 50 books, I need to try a bit harder. So thank you so much for watching this. I will talk to you again soon, and until then, bye.